Dear students, once again I am Dr. K. Kannan, Mechanical Engineering Department, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. This is lecture number 2 on steam turbine. The topic what we are going to discuss is work done and efficiency of impulse turbine. So in the previous lecture we discussed the construction of impulse turbine, where you have one set of nozzle and one moving blade. The steam enters the nozzle, reduces the pressure, velocity increases. With that higher velocity, the steam enters the moving blade to produce the work. So velocity decreases across the moving blade to produce the work. Now we take the moving blade of the impulse turbine. So V1 is the velocity of the steam leaving the nozzle. So here we have the nozzle. The nozzle, the steam leaves the nozzle with velocity V1 with an angle of alpha. And this V1 has got two components of velocity. One is vertical component, which is flow velocity. And another one is horizontal components, which is the whirl velocity. So V1 alpha, you draw on vertical line, VF1. We draw the horizontal line, VW1. And this moving blade is moving with the velocity VB. Now, VB is the velocity of the moving blade. V1 is the velocity of the steam. So, the relative velocity between these two is the, this is what the VR1. So, we have V1, we have VB, and this is what the relative velocity VR1. And with this relative velocity, the steam enters the moving blade and leaves the moving blade. So, flows through the moving blade and produces the work and leaves the moving blade. And here, the angle of VR1 is theta. That is inlet angle of the moving blade. And leaves with the angle phi. So, phi is the outlet angle of the moving blade. And you have the, once again, you have the outlet velocity and VB is there, and VB is the blade velocity. So, vectorial product of VR2 and VB is the V2, absolute velocity of the steam. Again, the absolute velocity has got the vertical component VF2 and horizontal component VW2. So, this is the inlet velocity triangle of the impulse turbine, and this is the outlet velocity triangle of the impulse turbine. Now, you draw the velocity triangle. So, necessarily, this is horizontal line, this is vertical line, this is inclined line, alpha, theta. And this is vertical line, this is horizontal line, inclined line, phi, beta. Why I am very specific is, majority of the students, they not draw this line as perfectly vertical line and this line perfectly horizontal line. Similarly, this line perfectly vertical line and this line is perfectly horizontal line. So, you be careful on drawing the velocity triangle. So, draw the velocity triangle and note down various terminology. VB is the absolute velocity. So, V1 inlet, V2 outlet. V is the absolute velocity and VB is the linear velocity of the moving blade. VP is the moving blade. VR is the relative velocity of the jet. VF is the flow velocity of the steam. That is the vertical component of V. VW is the whirl component, whirl velocity of the steam, that is the horizontal component of V. Alpha is the angle of the steam jet at inlet. Theta is the angle of moving blade at inlet. Beta is the angle of the steam jet at the outlet of the moving blade. And phi is the angle of the moving blade at the outlet. So, subscript 1 and 2, they represent the inlet and the outlet. And what are the forces acting on the moving blade? So, when the velocity is changing, the velocity V1 is entering here and leaving with the V2, which is lower, velocity decreases across the moving blade. So, there is change in the flow velocity, change in the whirl velocity, and change in the relative velocity. So, the change in whirl velocity, it gives the force which is required for moving the rotor blade or to produce the lift. The change in the flow velocity, that gives the axial thrust on the shaft of the machine. It gives some axial force. There is one more component perpendicular to the paper, which is radial velocity. it is again producing the radial force on the shaft. So the change in the axial velocity, the change in the radial velocity will not give any useful effect. The change in the wheel velocity, which is what giving the output, mechanical work output from the turbine rotor. And look at the how to calculate now the work output. So using the Newton's second law of motion, the net force acting in the direction is equal to the rate of change of momentum in the direction. Net force equal to mass into acceleration, mass into change in the wheel velocity, m into vw1, wheel velocity at the inlet, minus vw2. Why there is a negative sign of vw2? Look at the velocity triangle. So vw1 from the direction, vw1 from left to right, vw2 from right to left. So this is in the opposite direction. That is why we have the minus vw2. So net force or net tangent change in the tangential force or net driving force equal to m into vw1 plus vw2. And the power produced by the turbine equal to force into distance. So for what is the distance? Vb. So m into vw1 plus vw2, vb is the rotational speed of the rotor blade. And what is the axial thrust? Axial thrust equal to fx equal to m into vf1 minus vf2. That is what the axial thrust, which is to be taken care by the bearings. The bearings are the rotor shaft. Then blade efficiency, or diagram efficiency or rotor efficiency of the steam turbine. Eta B equal to work done by the blade divided by the energy supplied. What is work done? The power. Divided by what is energy supplied? It is in the form of kinetic energy of the jet, which is half mv square. So simplifying, we will get 2vb into vw1 plus vw2 divided by vv1 square. And stage efficiency. Stage includes the nozzle and the rotor. The stage efficiency is work done per kg of steam divided by total energy supplied per kg of steam. So vb into vw1 plus vw2 divided by h1 minus h2. So already we defined nozzle efficiency in the first unit. Nozzle efficiency is kinetic energy of jet per kg of steam divided by energy supplied per kg of steam. So kinetic energy is v1 square by 2 and energy supplied is h1 minus h2. So look at the three efficiencies. And what is the relationship between three efficiencies? Eta B, eta stage and eta nozzle. It takes some 10 seconds. Look at the three equations and find out the relationship. Write down the relationship. So if your answer is eta stage equal to eta N and eta B, you are correct. Eta stage equal to stage efficiency equal to nozzle efficiency into the blade efficiency. And there is one more factor, blade velocity coefficient, k equal to relative velocity at the outlet divided by relative velocity at the inlet. So when you look at the rotor once again, this is the rotor. So rotor, for the rotor, the steam flows with velocity vr1 and leaves with velocity vr2. The steam has got the contact with the rotor material. So there is a frictional losses. There is frictional losses. The frictional losses will retard, will reduce the VR2. So VR2 is always less than VR1. So VR1 is relative velocity at the inlet, VR2 is relative velocity at the outlet, VR2 is always less than the VR1. That is due to the friction on the rotor blade surface. So that is included here, that is calculated by the relative velocity at the outlet divided by relative velocity at the inlet. It is called as friction blade velocity coefficient or friction coefficient for the rotor blade. So for the frictionless flow, k equal to 1 or vr1 equal to vr2. There is another design parameter, sigma, blade speed ratio, which is blade speed divided by steam speed, vb by v1. So what are the terminology you have to remember? Blade efficiency, stage efficiency, nozzle efficiency, blade velocity coefficient and blade speed ratio. So the blade speed ratio we have to optimize. What is the optimum blade speed ratio for better efficiency? We take the plastic triangle, you write vw1 equal to vb plus vr1 cos theta, vw1 equal to vb plus this distance, which is vr1 cos theta. then VW2 is equal to VR2 cos phi, VR2 cos phi, the total length minus VB. Now adding these two, VW1 plus VW2, this gives VR1 cos phi cos theta plus VR2 cos phi. I take VR1 cos theta outside, it will become 1 plus VR2 by VR1 cos phi by cos theta. Already we defined VR2 by VR1 equal to K, friction coefficient or blade elastic coefficient. I take cos phi theta by cos phi by cos theta as a Z. So VW1 plus VW2 equal to VR1 cos theta into 1 plus K into Z. Or this VR1 cos theta equal to V1 cos alpha, this entire length minus VB. So VW1 plus VW2 finally equal to V1 cos alpha minus VB into 1 plus K into Z. Now, substituting the value in the blade efficiency equation, blade efficiency becomes 2VB into V1 cos alpha minus VB into 1 plus KZ divided by V1 square. So, this V2VB, you take 1V1 to the numerator, this will become V1 by V1 equal to 1, VB by V1 equal to VB by V1 into 1 plus K into Z. So, we know that sigma equal to VB by V1, so which is sigma. So, substituting here eta B equal to sigma into cos alpha minus sigma into 1 plus KZ. Now, look at this equation. Alpha is nozzle angle, which is a constant. K is the friction factor, is a constant. Theta phi, cos phi by cos theta is also constant. Everything is constant excepting sigma. So, to maximize eta B, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to sigma and Ek to 0. So, for constant value of alpha, K and Z, the blade efficiency maximum if d eta b by d sigma equal to d 0. Performing the differentiation, we will get 2 into 1 plus K Z into cos alpha minus 2 sigma, that is equal to, so equating to 0. So, optimum blade speed ratio VB by V equal to cos alpha by 2. So, this is again an important conclusion. Optimum blade speed ratio VB by V equal to cos alpha by 2. So, substituting this condition here in the efficiency equation, so efficiency maximum will be cos square alpha, maximum work done will be 2VB square. So, this is what the condition to be achieved for maximizing the work output from a single stage impulse turbine. So, this is the technique, this is the short, thumb rule or simplified equation used for designing a steam turbine. Okay, we'll take a quiz to understand, to evaluate our understanding of the subject. First question, power output of the impulse turbine is given by, you have four equations, look at the equations and you select the correct answer. So, P equal to M into VW1 plus VW2 into VB. Or P equal to M into VW1 minus VW2 divided by VB. Or P equal to VW1 plus VW2 by VB. Or P equal to M into VW1 by VW2 into VB. So, it is simple. A is the answer. P equal to M into VW1 plus VW2 into VB. The second question, blade efficiency of a steam turbine is given by, look at the equations and find out the correct answer. So, if your answer is B, eta B equal to 2VB plus into VW1 plus VW2 into VW1 square, you are correct. Then, axial thrust on a rotor of steam turbine, Fx equal to VF2 minus VF1 divided by mass, Fx equal to M into mass into VF2 plus VF1, Fx equal to M into VF1 minus VF2, and Fx equal to M divided by VF2 minus VF1. And if your answer is C, Fx equal to M into VF1 by VF2, you are correct. And the next question, blade velocity coefficient of a steam turbine is option A, K equal to VR1 by VR2, option B, K equal to VR2 by VR1, option C, K equal to VR1, V1 by VR1, option D, K equal to VB by VR1. And if your answer is B, K equal to VR2 by VR1, you are correct. So, optimum blade speed ratio, VB by V1, sigma equal to VB by V1 for maximum efficiency. You take your answer. The answer is given, sigma equal to cos alpha by 2. Thank you. We'll meet again.